Ballroom Rolex rankings number 2, Lydia Ko, into the interview room. Congratulations, a great 3 under par round today, 5 under par overall on the golf course. You're not one of the longest hitters on tour, and we kept talking all week about how this golf course was suited for long hitters. What have you been able to do on this golf course that's helped you to succeed so far over the first 2 days?
Coming into this week, I knew that this course was, I guess, a little bit of an advantage for the long hitters, but especially in a hole like 18, where it's like 210 yards to the pin, and kind of makes me feel like it's a reachable par 5. But I tried to hit the ball steady, and I've been pretty confident with the long game, and just gave myself as many opportunities as I could.
And you've noticed your first win on the LPGA Tour came while you were playing with Stacey Lewis. You won your first LPGA Tour as a member in San Francisco while playing with Stacey Lewis. Now you seem to be playing well again, playing with Stacey. You two talked about that you like playing with one another, but is there something about playing with her that brings out the best in your game?
I mean, whenever I play with her, she's playing great also. So, like for example, in San Francisco, we're feeding off each other, you know, making birdie, and you know, that's kind of what happened out there. I mean, she puts herself in a really good position that makes a lot of birdies. So, you know, when I go out there or when I see my name next to her, I make the green sheet. I'm pretty excited to go there because I learned a few things and playing alongside her. And I mean, she's just a great person.
Half the day went along, it seemed like there was some wind at times. Were conditions a little tougher today than they were yesterday?
You'd think that like in the morning there would be less wind, but and we had wind from, you know, just the first hole, and it kind of continued. But I think it was kind of forecasted to be like this all day anyway, but I guess everybody's playing in the same conditions. And wind definitely makes it a little tougher.
Opening it up for questions. Please remember to raise your hand and wait for a microphone. Go ahead, move back.
Just 17 years old, but do you feel like you're a role model for girls that are just 2 or 3 years younger than you? Do you see it that way?
No, I don't really see it that way, but you know, there are some times where you know, girls come up to me and say, oh, Lydia, you're my role model. And it kind of makes me feel special to get to be a role model when I'm still in high school. Only 17, and I mean, for them to think of me as a role model, it kind of makes me feel like I need to, you know, play better, you know, perform for good, and I can be that role model that they think of.
You can go back in right over here.
Please, I understand you're registered and hurting yesterday on the range, and you're warming up. Can you, and I know you went to get treatment after the round last night. Can you give us an update and you look right on there?
It definitely feels much better today, and I mean, it felt, you know, much less, you know, pain than when I was on the range, because when I got it picked up, and it's definitely been supporting my wrist, so it's not been going anywhere, but you know, it feels better in compared to yesterday, so I mean, that's good news for, it's, I guess, not getting worse.
Is it something you've had an issue with in the past that is flaring up again?
No, I've really had a wrist problem for a while, but to kind of feel it on the range yesterday when I was doing my drivers, it was quite different, and I couldn't really hold the club at one point, but no, it felt okay during my run yesterday, and I think if it stays like this, it's definitely, you know, I'm definitely playable with this.
Which wrist is it?
Lydia, never talking about being 17, you do have the opportunity this week, if you were to win this event, to become the youngest major winner in history. Do you think about those milestones as you hit them? I know we're talking about the youngest ever to reach $1 million on the LPGA Tour. When you have the opportunity for something like that, do you think about that at all? Is there pressure when you have those sort of things as a possibility?
You know, I think about, you know, winning at the end of the week. Especially, you know, like Toledo, I realized I became a millionaire after that. And I mean, to, I guess, kind of have those accomplishments is really cool. But I'm really going out there trying to play the best I can. And it's hard to control what I do, but to control what other people do is pretty much impossible. So you know, I'm going to go out there and just have some fun. I mean, I'll have to see if there's still two more.
that seems obviously suited for the big hitters, what do you tell yourself so that you don't put yourself in a hole right from the start?
I think the majority of the par fives are reachable for, the majority of the players. So I think that's where I try and think, okay, I need a birdie the whole, like 3 and 14, and kind of go from there and just give myself as many opportunities as I can. I wish I was a really long hitter where I can ball like 290 yards shot, but that's not the case. So I'm just trying to fit to my strength and hope.
I'm going to head over to Beth Ann right over here.
When you went to Universal and took some time off, was that a 5-day stretch of not touching the golf club that I heard about?
Yeah, I didn't touch the golf club for 5 days. I was actually going to take a whole week off, but David said, okay, let's have a lesson on 10 day. And so I said, okay, I better get back into it. And I wasn't hitting the ball really well last week. We were talking about, my swing was still on holiday until Sunday.
So, is that the longest stretch you've gone without a club in years?
No, not really. I had times where I took 2 months off or 1.5 months off because I'll be managing in the big year. I've done that a couple of times in the last 3 years.
So then this would be the longest stretch since you probably started the season off, right?
Yeah.
Can you go to Randy?
You said the point about Stacy, you like the idea that you can learn something from her. What have you observed from her or learned from her?
She, especially in heading, she just seems so relaxed in any kind. She kind of just strips the ball and makes it kind of happen, and majority of the time it goes in the hole. So to me, I'm kind of jealous that she's so relaxed, and those are the things
any more questions for Lydia?
We'll just go over the round.
Yeah, go over. Do you want to just have her go through birdies? Or, we have 6 birdies. Can you remember what you hit?
On the first hole, I hit my 6 iron a little short, like a 30 footer, and I hold that. I 3 footers, 3. I was on the green for 2, so I just went from 34, and I just kind of short-sided myself to the right and to make up and down for bogey. And then when I made par along the way, and then made another birdie on 8. I did it to about 8-9 feet and hold that. 10, I thinned my hybrid, but it ended up being 2-9. And I had kind of a 15-16 footer for birdie. And and then I had like a 2-3 footer for birdie on 12, and then bogey 13 because I went past and throw up. And then birdie 14, I made up and down from the front of the green, and that's
just a little bit of an interesting. Any other questions for Lydia? Thank you very much, and best of luck the rest of the weekend.